sense enjoyment. Okay? Not the karma, it's just karma, that's what it is. And in the last sentence, Prabhupada says, if we act according to Vedic knowledge, there's no question of being involved in sinful activities. Now, what Narada is saying is, if you want to go back to Godhead, then sacrifice is not a good way to achieve that.
Yeah.
Okay, but if your nature is so low, then to rise to the higher consciousness, then okay, you can do some sacrifice.
Okay.
That is one of the discussions are going on. Text 8.
Anyata karma kurvano
mana rudho nibadhyate
guna pravaha patito
nasta pragyo vrajati adaha. Otherwise, a person who acts whimsically falls down due to false prestige. Thus he becomes involved in the laws of nature, which are composed of the three qualities, goodness, passion and ignorance. In this way, a living entity becomes devoid of his real intelligence and becomes perpetually lost in the cycle of birth and death. Thus it goes up and down from a microbe in a stool to a high position in the Brahmaloka planet. So he's telling the king, this is what will happen to you if you just indulge in rituals and sacrifices. So, basically, the main point in this purport is ignorant and whimsical, not based actions that are not based on Shastra will lead to cycle of birth without real transcendental knowledge. So that's the whole Srila Prabhupada's point. I feel that's what it is. You guys should read it. Text 9.
Tatra nirvinna gatranam.
When King Puranjana was hunting in this way, many animals within the forest lost their lives with great pain. Being pierced by the sharp arrowheads, upon seeing these devastating, ghastly activities performed by the king, all the people who were merciful by nature became very unhappy. Such merciful persons could not tolerate seeing all this killing. So generally, those who are sadhus, sages and demigods, they don't like to see things been destroyed. But the demons enjoy those kind of activities. In the purport, towards the middle part, Srila Prabhupada says, because this is King Puranjana hunting, so in society, Prabhupada wants to talk about how people hunt also. Hunting women, drinking different types of liquor, becoming intoxicated, killing animals, enjoying sex, all serve as the basis of modern civilization. Now he's also hunting men, the same thing. Yeah. Vaishnavas are unhappy to see such a situation in the world, and therefore they are very busy spreading this Krishna consciousness movement. This is the reason why they are spreading the to help the fallen conditioned souls.
Mm.
Now you know what, why Prabhupada uses the word fallen conditioned souls, because we tend to do all these things and think we are happy.
Mm.
It's really not a happy medium for us. We are spirit. Okay?
Mm.
The devotees are pained to see the hunting and killing of animals in the forest.
Mm.
So recently there was a big article about one dentist in America went to Africa and killed a lion. He made a big issue about it.
Mm.
Yeah, because that lion was on a no-kill list, but he went and killed it.
Endangered animals.
Something like that. So a lot of people were unhappy and started attacking him and blah blah blah. Finally, I think nothing happened to him. wholesale, they don't want to see killing. So Vaishnavas don't like to see all this wholesale slaughter of animals in the slaughterhouses, and the exploitation of young girls in brothels that function under different names as clubs in societies. And you see that very common, very common, especially in places like in Russia, Japan, Korea. They like to employ young-looking girls like that. And even in Middle East, they do all this. It's not like they are very perfect. I don't know how long it will be before in India they are going to do all this.
Already
there. They are already doing
it. Illegal.
Being very much compassionate upon the killing of animals in sacrifice, the great sage Narada began his instructions to King Prachinabharhasa. So the reason for him even bringing up is because he is feeling too much compassionate to the animals. He also did this one other pastime also in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. You know?
Mrigari
the hunter. Yeah. So Narada Muni, as you can see, is consistent in his.
Yep.
It's not like only one place he's become. No. So Vaishnava is always
compassionate.
In these instructions, Narada Muni explained that devotees like him are very much afflicted by all the killing that goes on in human society. So in most of the other incarnations and so on, you will see that animal sacrifice goes.
Mm-hmm.
The only incarnation that said no was Lord Buddha.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But it doesn't mean, but he also rejected Vedas.
Mm-hmm.
But he came to for the reason of protecting the
poor animals.
Unnecessary killing of the poor animals. Text them. Shan Varahan Mahishan
Sasan Varahan Mahishan
Gavayan Guru Samyakan
Gavayan Guru Samyakan
Yanan Yanscha Vidan
Yanan Yanscha Vidan
Niknam Shramam Adyada
Vidan Shramam Adyada.
In this way, King Puranjana killed many animals, including rabbits, boars, buffalo, bison, black deer, porcupines and other game animals. After killing, the king became very tired. So basically he's doing sinful activities.
Mm.
And after a while people realize they are doing something wrong. If they have some good quality, they will otherwise they'll just continue. If they're totally covered, then there's no chance. And the Prabhupada says, in the Bhakti Rasa Amrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami explains that a man becomes sinful out of ignorance only. Alright? If you know what is right and wrong, you should be doing what is right. The resultant effect of sinful life is
suffering.
Remember the cycle?
Avidya.
Avidya will cause papa. Right? And papa will cause Kutam, Bija,
Prarabdha,
so it's all the same.
Is it Kutam, Bija, Prarabdha, and Prarabdha?
Yes.
Prarabdha is everything.
Yeah, it's manifest.
Partly, part of
prarabdha
it is
Prarabdha is manifest. Prarabdha.
And from Prarabdha karma, you can continue to sin again.
Cycle. Like
so those who are not in knowledge, who commit violations of the standard laws, are subject to be punished under criminal laws. Similarly, the laws of nature are very stringent. If a child touches fire without knowing the effect, he must be burned, even though he is only a child. In the next paragraph, Prabhupada says, the king became tired after killing so many animals. When a man comes in contact with a saintly person, he becomes aware of the stringent laws of nature. And thus becomes a religious person. Okay. So it's good to have association. That's one of the reasons why devotees go out to meet the other people also, the common people, so that they can get some conscience. Usually you act out of instinctively, I need this, I need that. Right? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But more and more devotees have become inward looking. They just do their own reading and
yeah, so
more and more inward looking actually.
It is like that, right? Not everyone is a Parivaka Acharya, right? Our Acharya Srila Prabhupada wants us to go and preach. But out of so many people, not everyone has that.
Most people I see, they are not interested. Bhajanananda is just sitting.
They want to be like Bhajanananda, but they don't even do that. Because they are too much involved in materialistic activities.
So then what is the hope? When we are talking all these big points,
yeah. So therefore,
we cannot stop killing of animals, we cannot stop opening up
portals. First you have to physician heal thyself. No,
but for the most part, after reading so much, people know what it is. They cannot heal themselves, that's a different problem.
No, the problem is they don't want to get healed.
So then the physicians don't want to heal themselves, but we are talking, like somebody made a statement recently in the temple, we are a preaching movement, so we know how to talk, but we don't know how to practice.
True, but that doesn't mean you don't preach, right? That's what Krishna wants, so we preach.
So that's also selfishness, right? What Krishna wants, I'll preach, I'll just take care of myself in a shell and I'll just go back
to God. Preach, the point is they're not preaching. How many people go out and preach? You're saying they're preaching. How many? No. Until they come to the level of self-realized understanding what they need to do, they're not going to go out and preach. Very few people will do that. Right? So therefore, you have a temple where you have an opportunity to help people, you know, make them understand. You do your duty. Now, to be effective, you must also do it. Right? Unless you do it, then how you can tell someone how to do it? Right? Just like the mother who brought a child to the guru and say, he's eating sweets, please tell him not to eat too much sweets. He said, come back in 30 days. And when she came in 30 days, then he looked at the child and said, don't ever eat sweets, it's not good for you. Then she said, you could have told 1 month ago. He said, 1 month ago I was eating it. Yeah. So same. You cannot say because we are not doing it, therefore we shouldn't preach. No, that's not the thing. You should understand what is required. Just like Prabhupada also, right? His Guru Maharaj told him to preach. And he also wanted so many other of his disciples to do, right? Not everyone could do the same instructions.
That's Prabhupada.
Yeah. So there are different levels and different categories of preachers and people who understand what to do, what not to do. In any case, if you say you understand, then you should be doing something about it. Then the point is, either the people who come, they only know superficially, and they think that's enough. Which means they really don't know what the philosophy is about. Whose fault is it? Right? So whenever you want to help somebody, you have to make sure they really understand the essence of it. I'll tell you, I remember one devotee, you know, initially devotee. So, we have school classes just like, you know, Bhagavad Gita classes and so. So then she had daughter and then I was encouraging her. And she said, no, it's too much, they're in high school too much homework and so they cannot focus on it. And I say, whatever you try to do for her in the materially, you know, she'll only get what she's due. You can send her to the best college you want also by pushing all this. But she's only going to land up in whatever is due for her. You cannot change that. And she said, is this your philosophy? She's initiated. I said, yes, this is our philosophy. You know, I said, if you do Krishna consciousness, it remains with you for the rest of your life. So you have to understand what they understand. But later on, a couple of weeks later, she brought her daughter to class. And she herself enrolled. So you must know how to tell people also. Not just, okay, they know, that's it, finish. No, you have to individually talk to them, see where they are at. It's not just, okay, I have a class, 6 weeks later I'll give you a certificate. What's the point? That's not what we are. We are meant to change their heart. Right? At least that's how I understand. I don't know what your understanding is. So it is very important for us to give that contact to people so they awaken in the heart that I am suffering, so I need to change my life. Otherwise, what we all are doing, right? We're just at the very low end, just above the animal life. We're not supposed to just remain there, right? What Prabhupada said, come to the platform of at least Madhyam Adhikara. Then you can go and help people. If you are at Kanishtha level, you won't help, and you can't help. That's the bottom line. Text 11. Tathashutrit parishranto.
Tathashutrit parishranto.
Vritto griham eivan.
Vritto griham eivan.
Kritasnano chitahara.
Kritasnano chitahara.
Samvivesha gata klamaha.
Samvivesha gata klamaha.
After this, the king, very much fatigued, hungry and thirsty, returned to his royal palace. After returning, he took a bath and had an appropriate dinner. Then he took rest and thus became freed from all restlessness. So generally, this is what the people work hard. They come back, they eat dinner, and then they take a shower immediately after work, eat dinner, watch TV. That's their relaxation. Because they're always in the mode of passion and ignorance. So they find that it's helpful for them. In the purport, towards the end of the first purport, Srila Prabhupada writes, according to Vedic civilization, he's talking about how people are always thinking of retiring, right?
Mm-hmm.
According to Vedic civilization, such retirement is positively recommended. So we also agree, retirement is a good thing. And this portion of life is called Vanaprastha. Retirement is absolutely necessary for a materialist who wants to become free from the activities of a sinful life.
Mm.
So that's the difference. Generally what they do retirement?
Golf
or go on cruise. And now that also they are afraid because all the boats sank, right?
Or infection, they land with an infection.
Or infection. I was just thinking, just see how Krishna is, you know, giving them different ways of reminding them this place is never going to be happy. This is what they do. Now, I'm not joking. Even there are so many people who come to temple and they know about Krishna, they know the philosophy, but they just don't want to surrender because they're addicted to making money. And then they're old, in their 70s, still they run business, they don't want to give it to their sons, they're afraid that they will spoil whatever they did. So, but they want to go, they're getting old really, so they want to go on cruise and so on. So they say, I'm going on cruise, oh, 2 week cruise down south, you know, very nice. Then they come back, they tell everybody. Because they got money, and people who want that kind of thing, they'll gather with them. And this happens in the temple, and you can listen, you know. And I went to this village and he's giving his sapta, whereas he won't come and sit and listen to Bhagavad Gita classes on Sunday feast. No, these are real life incidents, and this is what happens, you know. Because he's got so much money, nobody wants to tell him, you cannot talk like that.
That's a problem.
That's a problem. The leaders don't want that to happen, so they tell everyone, don't disturb this guy. That's how it is almost everywhere in the world. King Puranjanas, coming home, taking bath and having an appropriate dinner indicate that a materialistic person must retire from sinful activities and become purified by accepting a spiritual master and hearing from him about the values of life. This is applicable for everybody. Without the spiritual master, you know, initiating and taking our sinful life, we are in a sad situation. Right? So if that happens, then we feel rejuvenated. Then we can take up the process nicely. So that's what Prabhupada says. If one would do this, he would feel completely refreshed, just as one feels after taking a bath. After receiving initiation from a bona fide spiritual master, one must abandon all kinds of sinful activities, namely illicit sex, intoxication, gambling, and maybe. It may be that not everyone can do this.
Mm.
So therefore, only a few people would do all this, and then the others will be like congregation and so on who will support the system. That's how it's going to end up. That's the way, at least I see, happening in the world. People like the thing that we do, but they may not be able to do all of it. Yeah. Yeah, anyway, it may change within the next 10,000 years. Right? Text 12. Atmanam Marhyam Chakre.
Atmanam Chakre.
Rupale Pashnatha Dibihi.
Rupale Pashnatha Dibihi.
Sadvalankrita Sarvango.
Sadvalankrita Sarvango.
Manishyamadade Manaha.
Manishyamadade Manaha.
After this, King Puranjana decorated his body with suitable ornaments. He also smeared scented sandalwood pulp over his body and put on flower garments. In this way, he became completely refreshed. After this, he began to search out his kuma. So they said that the wife is the better of half of the husband, provided they are religious. But in general, that's quite common in society. When he comes into good consciousness, Prabhupada says, people look for spiritual preceptors or spiritual masters. Go and ask them questions, stuff like that. So here he's searching for a queen. So it indicates that his queen is the better in this sense, in this particular case onwards.
Mm-hmm.
It indicates that he is looking for his Krishna consciousness,
mm-hmm.
actually.
Mm-hmm.
So in the purport, in the middle, Prabhupada writes, just as King Puranjana began to search out his better half, the queen, one who is decorated with knowledge and instructions from saintly persons, should try to search out his original consciousness, Krishna consciousness. One cannot return to Krishna consciousness unless he is favored by the instructions of a saintly person.
Mm.
So this is very important thing. We wonder why we are not making advancements, because maybe we are not following the instructions properly, and therefore we are not blessed or favored. Therefore, Srila Narottama Das Thakur sings, Sadhu Sastra Guru Vakya Chitete Koriya Avya. If you want to become saintly persons, or if you want to return to our original Krishna consciousness, we must associate with sadhu, saintly persons, shastra, authoritative Vedic literature, and guru, a bona fide spiritual master. Now, if 90% of your time is spent associating with outside kalmi people, how much advancement do you think you can make? So these are things that you need to, each of us need to validate in our life to see why we are not making that change in our consciousness.
But Prabhu, that is required with our jobs, right? And we are grahasthas, we need to work, so...
Yeah, but we already discussed that in Prithu's part, right? But how he made sure everything is connected to Krishna. But to know how to do that, you must also get the association with us. So in the meantime, you need to like correspond, write to them for instructions, stuff like that. The temple is here, associate devotees who are able to guide you. Find people who are like-minded, who can help you. Text 13. Triptorishta sudritascha.
Triptorishta sudritascha.
Kandarpa krista manasaha.
Kandarpa krista manasaha.
Chasta vararoham.
Narya chasta vararoham.
Grihinim griha medinim.
Grihinim griha medinim.
After taking his dinner and having his thirst and hunger satisfied, King Puranjana felt some joy within his heart. Instead of being elevated to a higher consciousness, he became captivated by Cupid and was moved by desire to find his wife, who kept him satisfied in his household life. So it's interesting, when you read that, you think something else. But in the purport, Srila Prabhupada said, the verse is significant for this, those desiring to elevate themselves to a higher level of Krishna consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
Alright? When a person is initiated by a spiritual master, he changes his habits and does not eat undesirable eatables or engage in the eating of meat, the drinking of liquor, illicit sex, or gambling. And then a few lines down, Prabhupada says, due to his past sinful life, he became attracted by Cupid and eats good food voraciously. So sometimes you see that even on a neophyte devotee in Krishna consciousness because of past conditioning.
Mm.
It is clearly visible that when a neophyte in Krishna consciousness eats too much, he falls down. Okay? Because it disturbs him.
Mm.
So therefore Prabhupada warns those who are in the renounce order, like brahmacharis and vanaprastha, and of course it applies to even sannyasis, to be careful. Then he quotes what Narada Muni is the famous verse, Kyakta Swadharam Charanam Bhujam Bhajam. You all should know that. Right? This indicates that although a neophyte devotee may fall down from the path of Krishna consciousness due to his immaturity, his service to Krishna never goes in vain. So it is important to always be Krishna conscious. So you may fall, but that is not the point. Right? Sadhu eva
samantha.
So Krishna tells Arjuna, yeah, he may fall, but he is still sadhu because he is fixed. Fixed. Whole practice. In any case, one in Krishna consciousness must always balance their life. So therefore, you shouldn't eat too much, you shouldn't eat too little also. Artificially, you cannot do that. The body needs certain things, and you know how much you eat. Right? Like some people say, when you eat until you burp, like that, right? Or some people say, you eat and then you drink and then you burp. Different. The point is, you make sure you don't over indulge in any activity. Particularly in practicing Krishna consciousness, you don't do. You have to follow the rules very strictly and not break the rules. 15. Antapura Sriyo Pritcha.
Antapura Sriyo Pritcha.
Mana Eva Vedasa.
Mana Eva Vedasa.
Apiva. Kushalam Ramaha
Apiva Kushalam Ramaha
Shvarinam Yathapura
Shvarinam Yathapura.
That time King Puranjana was a little anxious and inquired from the house of women, my dear beautiful woman, are you and your mistress all very happy like before or not? Okay. So again Prabhupada says it's because the person is now trying to figure out about Krishna consciousness, so it's inquiring. But in any case, one shouldn't become attached to enjoying sense enjoyment unnecessarily. In wanting to perform devotional life, we should be very careful, as a beginner generally, right? We think, oh, we can enjoy and at the same time be Krishna conscious. But that doesn't help, because Prabhupada says the mind is always trying to enjoy and enjoy sense enjoyment without having to worry about breaking principles or sinful activity. The mind is always invested in that kind of enjoyment. Because unless you have a proper intelligence, the mind will always do that. But when as soon as we become serious in Krishna consciousness, then we find that the happiness we derive in material activities is not what we want. Right? But to come to that level, as I mentioned earlier, you all must have come to the stage of having a higher taste. And so Prabhupada quotes that, you know, Rasa Vajam Rasa Vyasya. So Prabhupada says in the end, in the last couple of sentences, one cannot be unattached to the sense objects unless he finds a better engagement in devotional service. One can cease from material activities only when one actually engages in devotional service. And you know that also. Whenever you have to do service, you're busy. You have no other material thoughts. As soon as you come back home and do other things, all those thoughts come back, right? You won't abandon your service and then say, I have to go and do my enjoyment and come back. You don't think that. You're thinking, I have to do this service. So therefore, actually engaging in devotional service is more than just doing one couple of hours a week or something. It's more than that. You have to constantly check yourself. And how you do it, even when you're working outside, is something you need to learn how to balance. How are you going to bed? You have some time for lunch. What do you do during your free time in your workplace? Do you sit with your friends and jibber jab, or you're going to take a Bhagavad Gita, or you're just going to listen to class and then take prasad? So there's many ways to make yourself focused. And on the other hand, yes, you have to work hard to show them that you can do very well, because a devotee always does his duties very well. So that's where you have to strike a balance. Text 15. Nata tai tarhi rochanti.
Nata tai tarhi rochanti.
Viheshu griha sampadaha.
Viheshu griha sampadaha.
Yadinasya grihe mata.
Yadinasya grihe mata.
King Puranjana said, I do not understand why my household paraphernalia does not attract me as before. I think that if there is neither a mother nor devoted wife at home, the home is like a chariot without wheels. Whereas the fool will sit down on such an unworkable chariot. So Prabhupada quotes again Chanaka Pandit. He has many amazing excerpts. He says, if a person has neither a mother nor a pleasing wife at home, he should leave home and go to the forest. Because for him there is no difference between the forest and home. The real mata or mother is a devotional service to the Lord, and the real patni or devoted wife is a wife who helps her husband execute religious principles in devotional service. These two things are required for a happy life. So in the next paragraph, Prabhupada says, one's household life is very successful if he has both a good wife and mother. And then he talks about how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had both of them. And even when he took sannyas, they also didn't give him any trouble.
Mm.
Okay. Otherwise, home life is meaningless. So then he says, unless one is religiously guided by intelligence and renders devotional service onto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, his home can never become very pleasing to a saintly person. In other words, if a man has a good mother or a good wife, there is no need of his taking sannyas. That is, unless it is absolutely necessary, as it was for Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So all of you don't need to take sannyas, because you all have good wife and good mother. Right? So all you ladies don't have to worry. Text 16. Pavartate sa lalana.
Pavartate sa lalana.
Majjantam vyasanarnave.
Majjantam vyasanarnave.
Yamam uddharate pratyam.
Yamam uddharate pratyam.
Deepayanti pade pade.
Deepayanti pade pade.
Can you let me know the whereabouts of that beautiful woman who always saves me when I'm drowning in the ocean of danger? By giving me good intelligence at every step, she always saves me. In the purport, Prabhupada says there's no difference between a good wife and good intelligence. One who possesses good intelligence can deliberate properly and save himself from many dangerous conditions. So similarly, a good wife will also save the husband from many dangerous conditions also, or giving good advice. So, and Prabhupada says good intelligence means becoming Krishna consciousness. Krishna ye bhaje se bada chatura. Unless one is Krishna conscious, he cannot be called an intelligent person. Okay. And generally in the Vedic times, the ladies also know these scriptures very well.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that they didn't know and they were dumb, you know. No, they were intelligent ladies, and therefore they were known as Dharma Patni. So if you remember in Mahabharata, how when they lost Draupadi, how she argued with the king and said, how can they put me? I don't belong.
After you are losing yourself, how,
yeah,
can,
how
you
can you put me like that? So so therefore they know, and so therefore they know as Dharma Patni.
Prabhu, in the previous verse, I'm still thinking, you said that we are not supposed to take sannyas because if we are a grastha and everyone is in Krishna consciousness in a family, husband and wife, then we can go there. But later on, when our duties are over, we can reduce them and focus more.
Preaching.
I'm not towards preaching.
Well, who knows? Maybe when you get old at that time, you may be able to do that.
Right.
That's vanaprastha.
So we can do that, right?
Yeah.
It's not that we have to live this grihastha life and
engaged
in that.
You can travel
to...
and preach, yeah. Ladies generally don't take that ashram, but you can travel and preach. You can get a few girls with you and go and preach. What's a big deal?
Or not even preaching, if I just want to focus on my
devotional
service,
that's
I
fine.
Can do
that's
that.
That's fine.
Right?
As long as you don't sit outside the temple and beg, it's okay. This is what they do in India. Oh, widows. Like that. So
they are all kicked out now.
Now they are kicked out.
Oh, in Vrindavan?
In Bengal?
Those ladies are different. Yeah. I'm just saying that sometimes they just do it to collect money.
Yeah, so they are actually.
Now we have this internet facility, so even you don't have to go out of the house. Through internet, actually, you can conduct classes or share your realizations to other women and they can benefit.
Not just women, you can preach to men. So there's nothing, no such thing. Yeah, but yeah, you can preach. The point is, you can preach. If you have life force, you can preach. Preaching means life force.
and I think we read in one of the Prabhupada's letter that woman is as lower, so women should not preach to men. Men are always higher.
Yeah, but you know, when you are much senior, older, there will be young boys and girls who can preach. What's wrong with them? You know, if you become too compartmentalized, then you won't do. You can go back to India and do like stay with the woman. But in the West, as long as you're there, because of the situation in this country, there's nothing wrong in preaching. Of course. Unless you are a young girl, then I would say, why are you preaching to young boys? Similarly, young boys shouldn't be preaching to young girls. But you're talking about when you're older and retired and all, by that time you should have paramdrisva nivartati. At that time you can preach. That's what we are saying.
Vishakha Mataji. Vishakha Mataji.
Vishakha?
Vishakha Mataji. Prabhupada.
Yeah, so she travels, because there are many. Dhanakeli Mataji.
Dhanakeli
Mataji. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So they are preaching.
Ramaporo.
And there are many people. Who is the other one? The education Mataji. Urmila Mataji.
Urmila, yes.
She goes so many places. It's not like you can't do, you can. And any case, let's come back to this. Dharma Pratija. Means chaste and Prabhupada writes towards the end of that paragraph. A chaste wife is one who never had any connection with men before her marriage. Once a woman is given the freedom to mingle with all kinds of men in her youth, it is very difficult for her to keep chaste. She generally cannot remain chaste. When butter is brought into the proximity of fire, it melts. The woman is like fire and man is like the butter. But if one gets a chaste wife accepted through a religious marriage ritual, she can be of great help when one is threatened by the many dangerous situations of life. Actually, such a wife can become the source of all good intelligence. With such a good wife, the family's engagement in the devotional service of the Lord actually makes a home a grihastha ashram, a household dedicated to spiritual cultivation. That's 1917, sorry. Rama Uchu
Naranatana Janimas.
All the women address the king, O master of the citizens, we do not know why your dear wife has taken on this sort of existence. O killer of enemies, kindly look. She is lying on the ground without bedding. You cannot understand why she is acting this way. Alright, so you know, the whole thing is, if you are a lusty person or materialistic, in the case of men generally, they tend to go, like Prabhupada mentioned earlier, woman hunting, sex and things like that. So even if they are married, they go and do that, right? In this country, if someone marries, the married men are happy because they can have bachelor party. And usually bachelor party means going to some stupid place to see naked woman. So all kinds of nonsense they do. So that is like a materialistic man. So they don't care if their wife is chaste or not also. Right? Prabhupada says they take the wife only as an instrument for sense enjoyment, not as a means for devotional service.
Mm.
Because they are so much in ignorance, they don't even know what devotional service means. And so therefore they have so much prostitution going on in this society. It's a sad situation actually. In the next paragraph, Prabhupada says, the wife of King Puranjana was lying on the ground because she was neglected by her husband. Actually, the woman must always be protected by her husband. We always speak of the goddess of fortune as being placed on the chest of Narayana. In other words, the wife must remain embraced by her husband. Thus she becomes beloved and well protected. So therefore it's important. And the wife is called Ardhangani, or half of the body. One cannot remain with only one leg, Prabhupada says. One hand or one side of the body. He must have two sides. Similarly, according to nature's way, husband and wife should live together. It is similarly ideal in human life, because he is comparing with animal life, where there are some species where they are always chaste. Like I think pigeons, right?
Crane.
Yeah. They only have one, and then if their partner dies, they won't get another like that. It's another animal also. Peacock? Oh, no, not peacock.
Not pigeon.
Not
pigeon.
Birds.
Dove, pigeon.
Small, very colorful birds. They also.
Like parrots. They're like parrots. Budgeries. They will only have one, and they cannot go for another. They'll die. So generally the home, Prabhupada says, must be a place for devotion service. The wife should be chaste and husbands also should be chaste and accepted by ritualistic ceremony. In this way one can become happy at home. So these are some points Srila Prabhupada raises to how to be chaste and how to act in a chaste way, both for men and women. What to do and what not. Text 18. Narada Vacha.
Narada Vacha.
Puranjana Swamahishim.
Puranjana Swamahishim.
Rikshava Dutam Bhuvi.
Rikshava Dutam Bhuvi.
Tatsangon Matita Yano.
Tatsangon Matita Yano.
Vaiklavyam Paramam Yayo.
Vaiklavyam Paramam Yayo.
Great sage Narada continue, my dear King Prachina Barhi, as soon as King Puranjana saw his queen lying on the ground appearing like a mendicant, he nearly became bewildered. Because she was lying, not taking care of herself, so the description is mendicant. In the end of that paragraph, Prabhupada writes, the purport is that one certainly becomes addicted to sinful activities when he becomes devoid of his good chaste wife, or when he has lost his good sense and does not take to Krishna consciousness.
Hmm.
So there are parallel understanding also. Okay? A good wife will protect her husband from going into sinful activities as well. Similarly, if you have good intelligence, you will take up Krishna consciousness. Text 19. Santvayan shlakshnaya vacha.
Santvayan shlakshnaya vacha.
Hridayena viduyata.
Hridayena viduyata.
Priyasya sneha sambandha.
Priyasya sneha sambandha.
Lingam atmani nabhyada.
Lingam atmani nabhyada.
The king with a grieved mind began to speak to his wife with very pleasing words. Although he was filled with regret and tried to pacify her, he could not see any symptom of anger caused by love within the heart of his beloved wife. So here, again, Prabhupada wants to emphasize about Krishna consciousness. He says, when a person loses his Krishna consciousness and loses interest in self-realization, he must engage in sinful activities. That's given, no? If you don't take to following a Vedic culture or spiritual life, then you have to be in the material life. Material life means being in
sinful
ignorance. And being in ignorance means you will commit sinful activities. So then Prabhupada says, all one's activities in a life devoid of Krishna consciousness simply lead to defeat and misuse of one's life. That means you have to take birth and go down to lower species.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why one has to be very careful. Naturally, one who comes to Krishna consciousness regrets his previous sinful activities in the human form. So that everyone must be thinking like that. Why I was like that? Why? So that is purification also.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't think and regret your past life, then something is wrong. But it's very, very purifying to think that we have made mistakes. Only by this process can one be delivered from the clutches of nescience or ignorance in materialistic life. So his wife represents not material intelligence, but Krishna conscious intelligence. That's how Prabhupada is discussing. Text 20. Anuninyeta sanakai.
Anuninyeta sanakai.
Viro nunaya kovida.
Viro nunaya kovida.
Pasparsha pada yugalam.
Pasparsha pada yugalam.
Aha chotsanga lalitam.
Aha chotsanga lalitam.
Because the king was very expert in flattery, he began to pacify his queen very slowly. First he touched her 2 feet, then embraced her nicely, seating her on his lap, and began to speak as follows. Prabhupada says one has to awaken his Krishna consciousness by first regretting his past deeds.
Mm-hmm.
So the king went to the jungle forest to do animal killing, so now he's apologizing.
Mm-hmm.
Just as Puranjana began to flatter his queen, one should by deliberate consideration raise himself to the platform of Krishna consciousness. Alright? So we have to also do the same thing, you know. We should know that we are very fallen, so we have to approach advanced devotees and ask them to guide us or you know, give blessings like that. So Prabhupada discusses how one can do that with the advanced devotee in the whole purport. At the end he says, in other words, one cannot arouse Krishna consciousness simply by his own mental speculation. One must surrender to a bona fide spiritual master. Only this process will help one. So this is very important, because we may be initiated sometimes but we don't surrender. So that also you have to keep thinking, why I'm not getting my Guru Maharaj's mercy? Maybe I'm not doing something wrong. So write and ask him, what should I do? Just like Srila Prabhupada wrote many times to his Guru Maharaj, say, what should I be doing? So sincerely you ask and you get good instructions. Text 21. My dear, beautiful wife, when a master accepts a servant as his own man, but does not punish him for his offenses, the servant must be considered unfortunate. Because, you know, Vedic culture, the master treats animals, even servants, as his own family member. Mm. Prabhupada writes, and therefore, they punish out of love, not for vengeance. Mm. Then in the Prabhupada writes in the middle, thus King Puranjana took his punishment dealt by his wife, the queen, as mercy upon him. So she didn't want to talk to him and so on. He considered himself the most obedient servant of the queen. She was angry at him for his sinful activities, namely hunting in the forest and leaving her at home. King Puranjana accepted the punishment as actual love and affection from his wife. In the same way, when a person is punished by the laws of nature by the will of God, he should not be disturbed. A real devotee thinks in this way. When a devotee is put in an awkward position, he takes it as a mercy of the Supreme Lord. This should be our mantra in life. Of course we chant the Hare Krishna mantra, but this should be our life experiences. And whatever you go through, you have to understand that we accept or any reversal in our life as benediction by God, good or bad. And then we thank the Lord and ask Him to give us the strength to go through difficult times, and just as well as for good times also. And not think that you deserve everything bad. Anything that is coming to you, we accept that it's our due to our past karma or misdeeds. And the Lord is kind, so He is not punishing us more severely than we deserve. So that's how we should always see. It's a difficult way, because sometimes there may be the most difficult situation He may test you. And if you cannot see Krishna in that situation, then you blame Krishna. And say, I've done so much and this is what you're putting me through. Then he's saying, well, yeah, I have to, so that you can come back to me quickly. But you're not listening. You're thinking, I have to have a better life, then I can come to you. Then he says, then you'll forget me. Okay, like that. So it's for our benefit. That, whatever karma is, you know, you can see it. Actually, karma is for our benefit. Because we made a mistake, so we are suffering. So we accept it and say, yes, I have made a mistake, I'm going through. But let me go through, give me strength to go through. Well, that we can pray. So Prabhupada says, if one accepts punishment as a reward dealt by the master or Krishna, he becomes intelligent enough not to commit the same mistake again. Okay, so like that. We will not do sinful activities. Text 22. Paramonu graho dando.
Paramonu graho dando.
Vritteshu prabhu narpita.
Vritteshu prabhu narpita.
Maluna veda tattanvi.
Maluna veda tattanvi.
Bandhu krityam avarshanaha.
Bandhu krityam avarshanaha.
My dear slender maiden, when the master chastises his servant, the servant should accept this as great mercy. One who becomes angry must be very foolish not to know that such is the duty of his friend. Okay. Papa compares the anger of a materialist to a snake. He gives snakes so much milk and banana, the poison increases. So similarly, such materialists, they only get angry the more you try to give them good instruction. So Prabhupada says, when a fool is instructed, he does not rectify himself, but actually becomes angry. So you have to become very intelligent, that when you understand this person cannot be instructed, then you have to find who can actually help this person. Or you can just pray for him, or you give the person some prasadam.